Today in the episode, Building 101, ways to one-shot your enemies, and not just with spears. Voice of the Wastelands, where we answer your questions and choose the craft of the episode. And we start with Workshop. Hot, spectacular, could be used for farming. Yup, it's the Draco. Is there a person who never ever wanted to stroll down a street of a wasteland town with a flamethrower in hand? Yeah, don't think so. That's why today we have a very special piece of equipment to discuss. The Draco, a legendary agricultural flamethrower. Works wonders in the garden, you know? The Draco, mentioned in the old tales, often had several heads, at least three. But you won't see many crafts using three Dracos at once. The thing is, most survivors don't actually see this flamethrower as a proper primary weapon. It's more of a special tool needed to tenderize the enemy before you deliver a final blow with the other essential piece of farm equipment, the harvester. And that's a fair assessment, more or less. But we are not going to be rational here. Nuh-uh. Give us fire. Give us madness. In other words, we just have to go for a pure flamethrower build. Let's see how far we can go. Before we start building, we have to state the obvious. Flamethrowers are quite finicky to use. Ammo packs and cooling modules are pretty much necessary. Almost as if a flamethrower is something you get when a cannon and a machine gun have a baby. You also need to be up close and personal with a target for your flamethrowers to be effective. And truth be told, the Draco doesn't make our job easier with its limited elevation angles. That's why we have to be very particular when choosing movement parts for our vehicle. We need something maneuverable, fast, and, if possible, inconspicuous. Like Bigfoot wheels. Perfect. If we're going to use these wheels, then it makes perfect sense to also use the combo that is almost as old as the mentor himself. The Gepard, plus Bigfoots, plus the Chameleon, so that we can be all stealthy. We're also going to use the Blight Cabin. It's pretty straightforward. The perk of this cab is too good to pass up. We need all the damage we can get. We're finally out. At first, it might feel as if we're not dealing enough damage, but don't rush to conclusions. Obviously, this build doesn't have the crazy burst of the full Draco Harvester combo, but you can still frag out if you go for a more deliberate approach. Choose your targets with care. Don't rush into things. Wait for a perfect moment to show your warmth. Ran into a nimble enemy? Chasing them down is not going to be worth your time. You're just going to lose your wheels. The best course of action in this situation is to pretend that you're not interested in the slightest, and then surprise them with a drop from the high ground, or an attack from around the corner. Remember, cunning and patience are the best friends of a modern farmer. Our crops might try to escape our warmth, but the harvest season is here. And now, a short commercial break.
Tired of fighting for a good spot near your campfire? Come to the Bottomless Pit Hotel. Bottomless Pit Hotel, an endless supply of hospitality.
Tired of wasting literal tons of ammunition to down an enemy? Played our Draco build from the previous segment for the whole day and have not an ounce of patience left? Maybe you just like to settle things fast. Well, there are ways to do just that. Today, we're going to discuss two time-tested one-shot techniques, and one experimental one. The first and the easiest option, yeah, you know it, a spear build. It's hard to surprise anyone with a good old spear build, so we decided to upgrade the standard design a little bit. Our spears are covered by armor, so that our intentions are not as obvious to our enemies. Everyone likes to be surprised with an explosion or two, right? Obviously, add-on armor makes the car heavier. It takes more time to pick up speed, and the vehicle is not as agile, but at least we don't lose all our spears after a single hit. It works! Our hearts are aching for something less mundane, though. The second approach, tested and proven by several generations of survivors, is to make a vehicle around the Tusk Cabin. Boosters, Bigfoot wheels, invisibility. Hit an enemy at high speed, and here it is, instant disintegration of the target. We've already covered this build at length in one of the previous episodes, so let's just lovingly pat the warm steel of the tusk and move on. Finally, it's time for the third option, which is a bit crazy. So, how does this blessed machine work? You see, we have some porcupines here, mounted in a specific way, so that our barrels go down. Then we have a kind of barrel collector, the purpose of which is to, well, collect all of that explodey fun in one place. You see where we're going, right? Barrels self-destruct in 20 seconds, so it's impossible to drown the whole valley with them. But you can easily get as many as 15 or even 20 at the same time. Then at the right moment, we use our rift and blow the enemy away with a tidal wave of explosive goodness. Happy to meet you. See you in the next match. What's important, this battle car isn't just a meme build. Even after you release the wave, you can still keep fighting by shooting your porcupines in the regular way. Then load into your next match and hand out free trips to the Barrel Sea again. Yoo-hoo! By the way, what are your favorite ways to instantly vaporize an enemy? Tell us about your builds, share your stories, suggest ideas for the Mad Lab. We'll read it all. Mateo Basquiera asks, could you add bigger visual explosions depending on which part gets destroyed, like ammo boxes or generators? Hi, Mateo. It's already in. But if something doesn't work properly, you can always submit a ticket. We're tinkering with explosions right now anyway. A survivor that goes by the name of LaVenVNR says, hey, I just have a simple question. What's the name of the Crossout OST group? I love your songs. Thanks. That's great to hear. The soundtrack for the game was composed by Andrew Romanov and produced by Samoilov. Do check their work out. Jeff Jeffson writes, also, some more farm equipment parts would be awesome. Tractor power! Hi, Jeff. We do like our repurposed farm equipment, but currently have no plans to add more of it. If we come up with something, though, we'll let you know. Then there's a message sent by one of our regulars, Al Coutinho. On the Clean Island map, there are balloons that could serve as a trap in battle. By destroying the balloons, you'd drop some kind of bomb or something that would damage enemy vehicles. What do you think? That's actually a very neat idea for a new interactive object. We'll discuss it with the team. Thank you. Finally, Mathis Builder asks, is there supposed to be someone inside the cabin? If yes, it means every time you self-destruct, you kill the driver? Huh. Huh. Well, if you're under 18, there's no driver. It's all just Ravager Wasteland magic. If you're over 18, it's up to you. And now, probably the most important part of the garage, where we show you a survivor-made vehicle from the exhibition. Today we have... wait, where's the car? Ah, here. Didn't notice you right away. So, the Derpeter, built by a mechanic that goes by the name of Super Ball. So what if it's tiny? Yep, it's no giant, but it hits surprisingly hard. It's quite durable as well. No joke. It takes quite a lot of effort to actually disassemble the thing. All in all, extremely effective for its size. Enemies are in for a bit of a surprise, to say the least. Great job, Super Ball. Thanks. That's it for today. Tell us what you think in the comments below, ask us questions, and when we finally grow tired of driving a yellow ball of awesomeness, we'll return with some cool content and some answers. If you like what we're doing, consider subscribing, leave a like, and good luck.